Thank you. Thank you. I'm George Benson, president of the College of Charleston. Welcome to historic Charleston. Welcome to the most beautiful urban campus in America. And welcome to the one of the most unique commencement ceremonies in the land. I'm so pleased to welcome the many members of family and friends that I see out here in the audience today who are here to celebrate the accomplishments of these terrific students to my left. Welcome all of you. As you know, the college has a deep, rich history. It was founded in 1770 by a group of men that included three future signers of the Declaration of Independence and three future signers of the U.S. Constitution. It's the 13th oldest university in the country. It's the oldest university south of Virginia. We've been educating students on these hallowed grounds since 1785. We begin our program with the national anthem, and by the way, the national anthem wasn't a part of this ceremony early years. It wasn't even written until 1812, but I hope you know the words. It will be sung by Claire Elitch. Claire is a sophomore vocal performance major. Claire.
Oh, say can you see early light, what so broadly wind at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars o'er the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we so gallantly streaming on the rocket's flame, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does the
Claire, that was beautiful. Please be seated. I would now like to introduce some of our platform party here on stage. Others will be introduced later in the ceremony. If you would please stand briefly when your names are called. From our Board of Trustees, our Chairman, Greg Padgett. And Board, please hold your applause. This will take a long time. Board Secretary, Frank Adston. Other trustees, Don Belk, Demetria Clemens, Cherry Daniel, Dwight Johnson, Marie Land, Annalisa Moorhead, Jeff Shills, and Joe Thompson. Both Dwight Johnson and Marie Land are longtime board members, and they are retiring this spring. And Dwight and Marie, I want to thank you for your many, many contributions to the College of Charleston, but especially the time and effort you put into our students. We thank you for that. Others I want to introduce, Trustee Emeriti, Joe Barry, David Watson, former board members, Charlotte Barry, Bobby Marlowe, the deans of our schools, representing Dean Alan Chow of the School of Business is Renee Mueller, Director of the Global Business Resource Center and International Business Program, Fran Welsh, Dean of the School of Education, Health, at Hewitt Performance, Mike Auerbach, Dean of the School of Sciences and Mathematics. Representing Dean Amy McCandless of the Graduate School is Dave Owens. Dave is Associate Dean of the Graduate School. Trisha Folds Bennett, Dean of the Honors College. And Godfrey Gibbison, Dean of the North Campus. Other guests, Other guests, Chuck Baker, president of the Alumni Association. Sharon Kingman, chair of the College of Charleston Foundation Board. Lynn Cherry, speaker of the faculty. Members of our executive team, George Hind, provost and executive vice president for academic affairs. George Watt, executive vice president for institutional advancement. Mike Haskins, executive vice president for external relations. Victor Wilson, executive vice president for student affairs. Catherine Bender, senior vice president for legal affairs and general counsel. All right, the attorney got a cheer. Brian McGee, chief of staff and senior policy advisor. And finally, while they will be more formally introduced a little later, I would like to welcome our honorary degree recipients, president of Trident Technical College, Mary Thornley, and South Carolina Lieutenant Governor Glenn McConnell. Governor McConnell is also our commencement speaker today. Now, as I look out at you, I realize the last time that you and I were all together was last Saturday night. Last Saturday night was a Charleston affair. And I happen to believe that's probably the best block party in the history of downtown Charleston, South Carolina. We want to make sure you come back next year, the year after, and the year after that. And we're working on maybe doing one in the fall as well, bring it back in the fall and in the spring. But today is another very special day, and I know it's one that you're never going to forget. You've had a remarkable four-year, sometimes four-year-plus journey here at the college, and the faculty and staff and I are most pleased to have taken that journey along with you. For most of you, your years at the college began in the fall of 2009, just as the Great Recession was bottoming out. That was a tough time, particularly for your parents and your grandparents and for our faculty and staff. And we were scared. It looked like our life savings may not stay intact much longer. We thought we might be wiped out. And yet here we are today. You know, 4 years later, things have changed. The economy is improving. The housing market is recovering in many parts of the country. People are hiring again. The stock market has recovered. In fact, last Tuesday, it went over 15,000, the Dow Jones Industrial Average, for the first time ever. So things are looking up. And you, well, over that same period of time, you perform much more consistently than the economy. And look what you've accomplished. Look what you've done over that short period of time. You progressed from high school students to college students to college graduates. And that's a remarkable period of time. As you look back and reflect on those college years, if you look back now or if you wait 20 years and look back 20 years, I doubt that the recession will even come to mind. Instead, I expect you remember your college friends, a special professor or two, a study abroad trip, a college organization. You got involved with an internship, a summer job. I recently asked you to share with me some of your favorite college experiences. I'd like to tell you about four of the responses that I received. Chemistry major Jenny Culp said her study abroad trip to Trujillo, Spain last fall was literally life-changing. The families who hosted Jenny and her classmates had little money, little material wealth, but their generosity, hospitality, and kindness were priceless. On long hikes in the mountains, Jenny learned to identify certain flowers, trees, animals. She witnessed up close another country's political process as political factions squared off for an election. She and her classmates grew close during the trip and even grew to view their trip advisors, political science professor Mark Long and biology professor Gorka Sancho, as surrogate fathers. Jenny says she came away from the whole experience with a deeper appreciation for how our interconnectedness as people transcends cultures, transcends races, transcends religions. Biology major Munali Patel discovered her passion for public health during her time at the college. Working with Professor Muntadi Nunda, Munani helped lead three student trips to Kenya from 2010 to 2012. In partnership with Project Harabi, the students administered medical aid and conducted HIV testing for villagers. Munali has used the experiences as a springboard to conduct undergraduate research and to pursue graduate studies in public health. Business administration major Christina Barry took full advantage of Charleston's quality of life. Oh, yes. And created memories that will last a lifetime. She'll always remember fresh crepes from the farmer's market, strolls along the Battery, lazy afternoons on Folly Beach, and mouth-watering desserts from Kaminsky's in the city market. Her only regret, so much to do, so little time to do it in, and she promises to be back. Friends of classmates of Thea Kozakis and Laura Stevens share a favorite memory with us. While struggling through a pop quiz in an upper-level physics class one day, Thea glanced over at Laura. Apparently, Laura was also having a tough time with the quiz. On her exam paper, and I'm not sure why she was looking at it, but on her exam paper, Laura had drawn a rainbow and a unicorn, and the words, "I was not prepared for this quiz." Lest you get the wrong impression of Laura and Thea, consider this. Last year, while studying infrared images of space, Thea and Laura identified a previously undiscovered planet outside our solar system. Incredible. NASA later confirmed the discovery. And since then, the students, along with their physics professor, Joe Carson, have received international attention for their find. Better yet, I think, a Canadian brewer who heard about the discovery named his latest pale ale in honor of the new planet. He named the beer Super Jupiter. Nice going, ladies. The college has also evolved over the last 4 years. We've raised the college's profile. We're becoming a national university with a global reach. Our faculty come to us from the best graduate programs from all over the country and, in fact, from around the world. Our students come from every single state and many foreign countries. Last fall, we had over 14,000 applications for about 2,800 freshmen and transfer seats. We've had some unforgettable moments and events on campus during your time here. One of them was when Charleston native Stephen Colbert did his Cistern Yard rally in his run for the presidency of the United States of South Carolina. That was back in January of last year. That rally drew the largest crowd and the most media attention of any of the events associated with the South Carolina Republican presidential primary. Literally more than 150 media representatives covered the event right here in the Cistern Yard. Many, if not most of you, were here that day. The event was later aired on Comedy Central's Colbert Report. Later that same day, CNN's Aaron Burnett and Anderson Cooper broadcast their news shows live from our campus, one on this side of Randolph Hall and one on the other side of Randolph Hall. And just last week, NBC's Today Show was broadcast live to the nation from this very stage. And I know many of you got up quite early that day and got in line to get in to see some of that production, despite the fact that it was exam week. And I hope things worked out okay, and apparently they did. Over the past 4 years, our student athletes provided many unforgettable moments. How about January 2010? I mean, who can forget that? That would have been the freshman year for most of you, when our men's basketball team knocked off North Carolina, the defending national champions. I will never forget that game. This year, it was our volleyball team that knocked off nationally ranked Miami in the first round of the NCAA tournament. Our women's tennis team claimed their fifth consecutive Southern Conference championship this year and moved on to the NCAA tournament. They are playing this afternoon in Lubbock, Texas, against nationally ranked Texas Tech. Last summer, our sailing team won the team race national championship. Yep, and at the end of this month, our women's sailing team and our co-ed sailing team will compete for national titles in St. Petersburg, Florida. By the way, on July 1st, we move from the Southern Conference to the Colonial Athletic Association. The move will offer the college significantly more East Coast and national visibility, more academic support, and better athletic competition. But for most of you, the most important of those three is the visibility. The Colonial Conference has teams in Boston, New York, Philadelphia, and Baltimore, which means employers up and down the East Coast will become more and more familiar with the college. And that means better career opportunities for you as the college becomes better known year after year after year up and down the Eastern Seaboard. Over the past 4 years, our philanthropic support at the college has grown dramatically. In fact, we've set fundraising records in each of the past 4 years, and this gives us significant momentum as we prepare to launch a national comprehensive fundraising campaign this fall. And by the way, we could not have achieved these fundraising results without the help of your parents. They've done some wonderful things for us. We greatly appreciate your support and your commitment. We hope you like what we're doing. We hope you'll stick with us and support us in the years ahead. Over the past 4 years, you have done us all proud with your community involvement, your internships, your service learning and research projects. Through our alternative break program, many of you have given up your winter and spring breaks in order to help others. You build a fence to protect the local elementary school's urban garden. You traveled to Atlantic City to take part in Hurricane Sandy relief efforts. You traveled to Biloxi, Mississippi to facilitate community conversations about poverty. And you spent time in Asheville, North Carolina, studying and promoting environmental sustainability. And your research and humanitarian efforts actually extended beyond that, well beyond that. They extended around the world. You taught English to children in the Dominican Republic, and you conducted medical checkups and provided health education in Guatemala. Several of you, under the mentorship of Christine Finnan, a professor of anthropology and teacher education, several of you traveled to India to carry out research that examined nutrition, children's literature, and other areas in rural Indian residential schools. We thank you for that. You've added so much, not only to the College of Charleston, but to the world. As you return to the campus in the next few years, you will see the fruits of our new campus master plan coming to life. You will see a state-of-the-art digital camp classroom building at the far end of Rivers Green that brings the latest teaching, learning innovations, and advanced computer technology to the college. You will see a renovated Simmons Center across the street here and a renovated Holland Science Center back here. And in August, a new residence hall and fitness center will open right there. You will see the college increasingly differentiated from other universities, and we think this is very important, differentiated by its innovative academic programs tied to the assets of Charleston, assets such as the port, historic preservation, the ecology of the Lowcountry, the tourism industry, African American history, urban planning, the arts, among others. We already do a very good job of incorporating Charleston assets into our academic programs and into our classrooms, I believe. But over the past few years, Charleston's economy has been rapidly transforming from a tourist and navy town over the last 100 years to a diverse, complex, modern economy. The change has been so rapid and so far-reaching that I refer to today's economy as New Charleston. New Charleston is driven by both the traditional assets that I just listed and the new and emerging assets of aerospace, of course, led by Boeing. Boeing went from zero to 6,200 employees in 3 years here in Charleston, and I believe they're heading toward 12,000. Healthcare and biosciences and digital media and technology. We now have 250 software firms in Charleston, where we had about a dozen a decade ago. Today, the college is investing in and supporting academic programs that align with and take advantage of both Charleston's existing assets and its emerging assets. And by doing so, we will differentiate the college from all other universities in the world. There is far too much duplication in higher education today, both within states and across state lines. By focusing on the assets and needs of the Lowcountry and Charleston, we will not waste resources duplicating what others already do. Every university doesn't have to offer every possible degree program. You will also see the college doing more collaboration with the Medical University of South Carolina as you come back over the years. Collaboration will help support and expand Charleston's economy while improving the quality and depth of our degree programs and growing the national reputations of both institutions. And as I explained to you in an email 2 or 3 weeks ago, it may even turn out that someday the college and the medical university will join forces. In such a scenario, the college would serve as the core. MUSC's 200 undergraduate students would join our 10,000 undergraduate students. MUSC's 2,500 graduate students would join our 1,500 graduate students. The combined universities would be about 14,000 in size. Most importantly, all of these ongoing and future initiatives will increase the value of your degrees. That's my job. That's my only job, is to increase the value of your degrees. And that's what we will focus on, and that's what we do focus on. But to achieve some of that, or all of that envisioned future that I just went through and talked about, we can't do it alone. We need your help as well. In a few minutes, you will become alumni of this historic university. You will join a network of more than 55,000 alumni around the world, a network that will benefit you throughout your careers if you reach out and take advantage of it. Don't wait for it to come to you. Go after that network. We've got a big part of it sitting on the stage here today in front of you. But just as you needed us to reach the gateway to your career today, we need you to help the college reach its potential. We need your expertise, we need your advice, we need your feedback, we need your help as advocates for the college in recruiting new students and strengthening our relationships with the many institutions you will work with over your careers, and in also building relationships with the communities that you will be living in around the country and around the world. Think of us, please. We need your help in continuing to build a vibrant and responsive alumni network. And yes, we will need your financial support. You will be hearing that from me and my successors once, twice, maybe three times a year for the rest of your lives. Please open that mail, open those emails, and send us something. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, for the conferring of honorary degrees, I now will be joined by Board of Trustees Chair Greg Padgett. Trustees Don Belk and Joe Thompson, would you please escort Mary Thornley to the lectern? President Thornley will be presented for an honorary degree by Trustee Cherry Daniel.
When Mary Thornley moved to Charleston with her husband in the early 70s, her plate was already full, taking care of two young children. But the demands of her motherhood didn't stop her from taking a night job as adjunct professor, teaching speech and English. Little did Dr. Thornley know that when this part-time work would be the beginning of nearly 40 years career at Trident Technical College here in the Lowcountry. And it didn't take long for her to fall in love with the place. Dr. Thornley, you see, was one of the only two graduates to head to college from her high school class in the mill town of Concord, North Carolina. Wouldn't it have been something, she thought to herself, if a place like Trident Tech had existed in her own hometown? So many more of her former classmates, she believed, could have expanded their education as well. Dr. Thornley, now the president of Trident Technical College for 22 years, is proud to tell you that behind the University of South Carolina, Trident Technical College serves the largest population of undergraduates in the Palmetto State. There are all types of students at Trident. Many, she says, are smart people who didn't fully appreciate and develop their intellect before coming to Trident. Others are students who needed a few years off from education after high school before pursuing a degree. And yet others find it more affordable and advantageous to take courses at Trident before transferring to another university. And though all of these generalizations are helpful in understanding who makes up Trident Technical College, Dr. Thornley is quick to point out that each student has a unique and sometimes challenging circumstances that affect their ability to obtain an education. She can tell you of a student whose experiences with severe seizures motivated him to become a paramedic. She can tell you of a woman who is studying horticulture as a way to cope with the loss of two young children. She can also tell you about a nursing student with good grades whose performance recently and suddenly slumped. It turns out the student had become homeless and was living out of her car in a college parking lot. Fortunately, Dr. Thornley was able to use college emergency funds to get the woman back on her feet. She has thousands of those stories rattling in her head at any one time, and she makes it a point to get out of her office and around Trident's seven sites and campuses. She enjoys monthly meals with student leaders, allowing them to ask her and her staff any question they desire. And though she's worked many positions at Trident Tech, and she's climbed her way to the top leadership post, one thing has remained constant: her passion and for education. For those of us who live and work in Charleston, we can attest to the tremendous impact Dr. Mary Thornley has made in developing Trident Tech into the top technical college in South Carolina. But equally important, her leadership and passion for education impact so many professional educators, including myself. It is with my pleasure to present Mary Thornley. Her noble and longstanding service to generations of students makes her fitting for the candidate of the College of Charleston, Doctor of Humane Letters.
Mary Thornley. Your undiminished passion for education and your able management of Trident Technical College during a period of significant growth have benefited countless students, their families, and our community. Your accomplishments and endurance are worthy of great respect, The College of Charleston is proud to confer upon you the degree of Doctor of Humane Letters.
By the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees of the College of Charleston, I now confer on Mary Thornley the honorary degree of Doctor of Humane Letters with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities thereto appertaining. Congratulations, Dr. Thornley.
It's an honor, both personally and professionally, for me to be given the responsibility of presenting the honorary Doctor of Humane Letters degree to the South Carolina Lieutenant Governor, Glenn F. McConnell. I've known him since I was a student here at the College of Charleston many years ago. It's a tradition in South Carolina to refer to the Lieutenant Governor by the title of Governor when personally addressing him. Because I've been friends with Governor McConnell since my college years, with his permission, I'll refer to him in the following honorary degree presentation as Glenn. Before Glenn became South Carolina Lieutenant Governor, before he was the leader of the state Senate, the chairman of the state Senate's Judiciary Committee, and the chairman of the state Senate's Committee on Rules, he engaged in a political trial run that prepared him well for representing a diverse and demanding constituency. Glenn, you see, served as the student body president at the College of Charleston. That was 1969, his senior year at the college. In the decades since, Glenn has built on that experience to become one of the most esteemed public officials in the history of South Carolina, revered for his integrity and respected for his legendary knowledge of legislative rules and procedure. In short, Glenn has been recognized as an extremely able and ambitious elected official whose obvious passion for public service and the Palmetto State have earned him the privilege of serving as a South Carolina senator for more than 30 years. For a long time, many people consider Glenn the most powerful man in the state, able to enact or remove any proposed laws. As one fellow lawmaker said of his colleague and his legislative prowess, just as Ronald Reagan was the great communicator, Glenn is the great facilitator. He has also been instrumental in the protection and preservation of the H.L. Hunley, a Confederate submarine that was the first submarine to sink a ship in battle. Discovered in 1995 off Sullivan's Island, buried under silt and more than 30 feet underwater, the Hunley was recovered 5 years later and is undergoing sensitive restoration at the Warren Lash Conservation Center in North Charleston. More recently, in 2012, upon the resignation of South Carolina's Lieutenant Governor, Glenn assumed that role, which includes heading the Office on Aging and serving as an advocate for the state Senate senior population. He also has served as the chairman of the African American History Monument Commission. Away from the State House in Columbia, you may find Glenn participating in Civil War reenactments as a cannoneer or enjoy jet skiing on nearby Lake Moultrie. First and foremost in his life, however, has always been his service to the people of South Carolina and the operation of efficient and responsible government. It's my pleasure to present Glenn F. McConnell, his exemplary service to the people of North Charleston and the entire state of South Carolina, make him a fitting candidate for the college's Doctor of Humane Letters. Glenn F. McConnell, you have worked for decades as a senator and lieutenant governor to safeguard South Carolina's constitution and government, protect its citizens, and prepare for an even better future for the Palmetto State. The College of Charleston is proud to confer upon you the degree of Doctor of Humane Letters.
By the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees of the College of Charleston, I now confer on Glenn F. McConnell the honorary degree of Doctor of Humane Letters with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities thereto appertaining. Congratulations, Dr. McConnell. Thank you for being here. It is now my pleasure to introduce our commencement speaker, and guess who it is? Governor McConnell. You already know a lot about him. I'll tell you just a little bit more. Glenn was born here in Charleston. He graduated from St. Paul's High School in 1965. from the College of Charleston in 1969 and from the University of South Carolina School of Law in 1972. He was elected to the South Carolina Senate in 1980 and served for 32 consecutive years before becoming Lieutenant Governor in March 2012. We're pleased also today to have with us Glenn's sister, Deborah McConnell, and his brother, Sam McConnell. If they would please stand, please, so we could recognize you. Over here. Deborah and Sam, thank you for being with us. Glenn, stage is yours.
Thank you, sir, President.
You're welcome.
Well, let me start out by saying it's hard for me to believe how many years have elapsed since I sat on this. We could see the cistern back then. There weren't that many of us, but underneath here on the cistern, made the walk for my diploma and left here to begin to chart my life. I remember Dr. Harry Freeman and Dr. George Grice, Madame Stafford, and all of the wonderful people over the years, Ted Stern, and that were here when I was here. But 40 years later, I stand before you, much older, hopefully wiser, and I have just a few brief moments. They've limited with us politicians to make sure we understand how many words. So let me offer you a little bit of advice to all of you who are now getting ready to chart your own course. So in my effort to boil it down to a lifetime of experience, I decided I would share with you some of what I say to leadership groups who visit the State House. Although my remarks are aimed at persons in leadership positions, these remarks are relevant to any audience because they really apply to everyday life and about living a quality of life. I tell them that leadership will present them with challenges and choices, and how we confront those challenges will define our personality and sometimes change the course of our lives. I talk about integrity, I talk about sacrifice, and I talk about service. But among all of the challenges I discuss, I believe that the most important challenge and the most difficult challenge that they will confront is that of integrity. You either have it or you don't. You either keep it during difficult times of difficulty, or you succumb to what is easiest or more attractive. Integrity requires you sometimes to tell people what they don't want to hear. And you'll often be tested throughout your life to see if you still have it. My personal and professional integrity was put to the test last year. For those of you who may not have known me before, I became the Lieutenant Governor, or may not have followed the events that befell the office of Lieutenant Governor over the past year up until March of 2012, because there's nobody out here who voted for me for Lieutenant Governor. I had served in the State Senate for 31 and a half years representing the people of District 41 in Charleston County. I enjoyed my service in the Senate. In fact, I was living my political dream. I'd moved to the top. I was chairman of the Senate Judiciary Committee, and I had achieved my ultimate goal of becoming the president pro tempore of the South Carolina Senate. Then my world changed. In March of 2012, Lieutenant Governor Ard pled guilty to ethics charges and resigned his position. According to the state's constitution, it was my duty as president pro tem to resign my Senate seat and take the office of Lieutenant Governor. Many of my friends and supporters, political advisors, encouraged me to resign as president pro tempore before Ard's resignation in order to sidestep the issue and enable me to stay in the Senate where I wanted to stay. However, to me, the Constitution was very clear, and in my mind and in my heart, I knew that the duty to the oath I had took to uphold the Constitution was my only choice. During my entire political career, I pledged myself to the integrity of the Constitution, and I fought on the Senate floor against those who would twist it or manipulate it to their personal or political gain. Crisis like that demands leadership. So reluctantly, on March the 13th, I took another oath and I became the Lieutenant Governor. Despite the demise of everything that I had worked so hard to achieve, I could not in good conscience look myself in the mirror each day thereafter, knowing that I had manipulated the rules to fit my personal desires. Doing the right thing, even though it may mean great personal sacrifice, may lead you to an opportunity you never thought possible. And let me explain. I have to admit again that when I took the oath of Lieutenant Governor, it was with a very heavy heart. But never in a million years did I imagine that there was a greater purpose for what had transpired. It took me only a few days to discover that I had a new challenge for my life, possibly the greatest challenge of my career. As head of the Office on Aging and chief advocate for seniors and vulnerable adults in our state who are in a situation they're in either because of time or because of birth or because of accident. Since I took office, I learned that the senior population in our state is going to double in the next 15 years, and our state has not prepared for what I call the gray tsunami. What most people don't realize is that unless plans are implemented soon to provide care for people who cannot care for themselves, all South Carolinians will bear the brunt of our failure to act. Although it's not the challenge I expected at this point in my life, it is certainly one that will provide me an opportunity to continue my public service and perhaps touch the lives of many of my fellow South Carolinians. When I visit the homes and look into the lonely eyes of shut-ins who need a meal a day delivered in order to stay in their homes, or hear the gratitude expressed by seniors when I visit their senior centers, or other types of assisted living and nursing facilities, I know that that was the road that I was destined to travel, and I feel blessed to have the opportunity. So to sum it up, the most important value you can carry with you in life is integrity, to strive to do the right thing. Listen to that inner voice and it will speak to you. If you fail to listen to it, it'll stop talking to you. It will lead you down the right path, even if you don't understand why sometimes your original dreams go unfulfilled. Life is about a series of opening and closing doors. It's no straight line path. Following the correct principles and the inner voice of your own conscience, though not immediately popular with oneself, will take you on a life's course you otherwise will not experience. For me, I got the chance to see up close the face of aging and the opportunity to use my life's legislative experience as a gift to meet that challenge. You too are going to face the doors of choice and have the chance, by correct choices, to take this gift of education that you've received here at the College of Charleston and the experience and make a life for yourself and for others. Your final destination will be worth the trip, and it may lead you to something wonderful as it did for me. The right leadership for yourself not only involves integrity, but it also involves sacrifice and service. Down the road, you'll be called upon to give your time, your money, your talent. You'll be asked to reinvest yourself in your family and your community. Giving time to pursuits other than fame and fortune will give you a sense of satisfaction that money cannot buy. Integrity, sacrifice, and service, it's the ultimate path to a successful life. It was summed up best by Sir Winston Churchill when he said, "You make a living by what you get. You make a life by what you give." I congratulate you today on your great accomplishment and wish for you every happiness in the life ahead. Thank you.
I think it's a powerful lesson for these future leaders, but indeed it's a powerful lesson for all of us. Thank you, Governor. Provost George Hind, will you please join me up here and announce the recipients of several important awards?
Thank you, President Benson. I have the opportunity here to recognize some very important faculty, students, and some distinguished individuals as well. I have the opportunity first to talk about our faculty distinguished awards. And would each of you stand as I call your name and remain standing until all awards have been announced? Everyone, please hold your applause until all have been announced. The Distinguished Advising Award is given each year to faculty and or staff members who have demonstrated a dedication to our students in the advising area. This year, the recipient of the Distinguished Advising Award is Professor Genevieve Hay in Teacher Education. The Distinguished Teaching Award is awarded each year to a member of the College of Charleston faculty in recognition of those outstanding qualities which typify the finest expression of teaching. This year's recipient is Professor Anna Oprison. Anna is in the Department of Physics and Astronomy. The William V. Moore Distinguished Teacher Scholar Award recognizes and honors colleagues who exemplify the teacher-scholar model and whose exemplary scholarship and teaching have enriched the intellectual lives of our students throughout the recipient's career. This year, the recipient of the distinguished the William V. Moore Distinguished Teacher Scholar Award is Professor Sornell Operson, in the department, also in the Department of Physics and Astronomy. I'm grateful to you all as faculty and all of our faculty as they make contributions to our incredibly productive, student-focused that characterizes the College of Charleston. Thank you. The William Aiken Fellows honors 4.0 graduates, and the Bishop Rivers Smith Award is the next one I would like to talk about. We're pleased to recognize the fourth graduating class of William Aiken Fellows, those students who are the ones bearing medals hanging from gold and maroon ribbons. Aiken Fellows are all members of our Honors College and were selected based on superior academic performance. As Aiken Fellows, they have participated in a range of activities aimed at their development as scholars and professionals in their fields of choice. All are graduating at least with magna cum laude. Of the 12, 10 have had an international experience as an undergraduate, and even more remarkably, in 10 different countries. 6 have completed internships outside of Charleston. 4 have been accepted to graduate programs around the country. 1 is a Rotary Global Scholar who will pursue a graduate degree at the University of Sussex in England. 2 were finalists for Fulbright Student Research Grants, and 1 received a Student Fulbright Research Grant to study at the University of Manskirk. 2 will teach English in Europe, and 1 will pursue a career with the Federal Reserve. Finally, 2 of the Bishop Robert Smith winners are members of this society. At this morning's ceremony, we have 3 perfect 4.0 graduates. Would each of you rise as I call your name? And one of them, unfortunately, is not with us this morning. Caroline Elizabeth Graham in early childhood education. And Heather Elizabeth Wright in biochemistry. Congratulations to you. The Bishop Robert Smith Award is the highest honor a student can receive during his or her career at the College of Charleston. Recipients of the award are chosen on the basis of demonstrated leadership and academic excellence. I'm very pleased to announce today that at a recent award ceremony, the Bishop Robert Smith Award was presented to Kate Scheidler from Cheshire, Connecticut, Levi Vonk from Kingsland, Georgia, and Liza Wood from Simpsonsville, South Carolina. Each received a plaque, a medallion, and a $500 check. They will attend the ceremony this afternoon. Congratulations to them. Now I would like to introduce the students in the platform party that are with us today. Erica Arbetter is president of the Student Government Association, and Alex Pappas is representing the senior class. Alex will make remarks on behalf of the senior class, and she will be followed by Erica with remarks on behalf of the student body. Thank you.
Unforgettable, dynamic, life-changing. These are a few words that my fellow seniors use to describe their experiences here at the College of Charleston during their irreplaceable years. Look around you, feel the humidity, hear the sounds of our bustling city, smell the seafood. This is something that we had the privilege of waking up to every day during our time here at the college. Charleston is growing, and our class had the opportunity to grow with it. Voted top tourist destination in the world by Condé Nast, this was the greatest place to learn and grow. Even Stephen Colbert and Kathy Leon Hoda realized this as they stepped onto our campus and never wanted to leave. This was the feeling that we had as freshmen, and aren't we glad? Convocation seemed like so long ago. As we passed through Porter's Lodge Arch to symbolize the beginning of our intellectual journey here at the college, As you know, after we step off of the stage and walk underneath the arch that reads, "Know Thyself," we will be ready for the world. But first, let's reminisce on our unforgettable years together. Who could forget when the College of Charleston basketball team beat UNC Chapel Hill? As we came together as Cougars, or just relaxing and doing homework in the Cistern Yard under these beautiful live oak trees. Or our annual year end of the year celebration, Cougar Palooza. And of course, there is a Charleston affair. But let's not forget that we also studied here at the college. Yep. Our senior capstone is definitely something that we have learned from. In the School of Business, you learn to work with a team, as we spend a lot of time together in your group building a business plan from the ground up. Woo! In the School of Education, Health, and Human Performance, you build patience and leadership skills as many of you stepped into the classroom as a role model and teacher for the first time. In addition, you develop critical thinking skills through hands-on learning. And in the School of Sciences and Mathematics, problem solving was a must for you to get through day-to-day studies. So, remember these dynamic skills, life-changing experiences, and know thyself as you enter into the real world, whether you move on to grad school, a big person job, or even backpack through Europe. Congratulations, class of 2013. We have done it. Go Cougars.
First and foremost, I would like to state how deeply honored I am to congratulate the graduating class of 2013 on behalf of the entire student body. Michael Dell once said, "Try never to be the smartest person in the room. And if you are, I suggest you invite smarter people or find a different room." In professional circles, it's called networking. In organizations, it's called team building. And in life, it's called family, friends, and community. What Dell didn't emphasize, though, is that it starts here. It is here in our 10-block urban oasis that you learned the value and the importance of building relationships both on campus and in our greater community. Each of you have different reasons and experiences that brought you to this stage, and yet you make one collective whole. That is what it means to be a College of Charleston graduate. You are unique. You are well-rounded. You understand and appreciate the value in a group of passionate, driven individuals. That is the college's gift to you. What you choose to do with it is your gift to the college. To see the extent of our community values, one has to look no further than your fellow classmate, graduating senior, Bailey Barnes. By administering CPR, Barnes heroically saved the life of his best friend. His actions resulted in the proposal of a South Carolina Senate bill that would require these proper CPR instructions for all high school students. That is our community at work. Bailey's story is just one example that it does not matter what you are doing, where you are, or how you're doing it, only that you are now and forevermore carrying the College of Charleston name and have a worldwide community of support behind you. Now, before you take that much-anticipated walk, I ask you to take a pause, look around, and really see your classmates. Remember their faces, their families, their friends. Now, thank them. They are the ones who will make this a greater college for generations to come. As much as you have prepared to take with you today, you are leaving even more. And when I see all of you at a Charleston affair next year, I will be proud to say I am a part of your class's community. And even though you are leaving them today, you will always be a part of our hallowed grounds because, like you, they are a part of our community, too. So congratulations, class of 2013. We will be seeing you. I would now like to introduce Chuck Baker, class of 1980, who will be speaking on behalf of the Alumni Association.
Wow, what a beautiful morning, and for those of us up on the stage, the overcast really is more beautiful than the sunshine. Don't you agree, seniors? For an incredible time in your lives. It's a real honor for me to take part in your graduation today. As president of the Alumni Association, I welcome you as our newest members. At the end of today's ceremony, you will join the more than 55,000 alumni of the College of Charleston. You'll be a member of an alumni association that was founded in 1888 and exists to serve the welfare of the College of Charleston. As you get ready to start this new phase in your life, I'd like to share a few thoughts with you as someone who was sitting on the cistern where you are today, 33 years ago, but in some respects, it really does seem like yesterday. First, stay informed about the college and stay connected with your friends, who will be some of the best friends you will ever have in your life. You can do both at MyCFC on the alumni website, and yes, come back to the Charleston Affair every year and you can actually see them in person. Next, get involved. We have 30 alumni chapters throughout the United States and overseas, and we're adding more every day. If you move to a city with a chapter, go to their events. If there's no chapter in your area, think about starting one yourself. Last, give back. Keep up a philanthropic spirit after graduation. As the money our school gets from the state becomes less and less, alumni giving is crucial to make sure those who came after us get the same great education we had and have the same incredible experience we did. There's a tradition at the College of Charleston involving the class ring. Before graduation, students wear the ring with the seal facing in, but at graduation, the ring is turned so the seal faces out. This indicates you are now alumni of the College of Charleston and ready to go out in the world. So if you have your ring, turn the seal outward. If you jump the gun on that, just do a 360 and we'll pretend. Finally, make the most of the education you received here. You are well prepared for whatever path you take. I salute you in your achievement. Congratulations and good luck to all of you. And just remember, the Alumni Association will always be here for you. Thank you.
Now, for the reason we're here today. I know you've been waiting. First, however, the RTM baccalaureate degree will be awarded, the AB degree. The AB degree in classics at the College of Charleston requires a significant coursework in both Greek and Latin. Other AB majors across the country at other universities require significant coursework only in Greek or Latin. The College of Charleston has awarded this degree for more than two centuries. That grand tradition continues today. Will the following candidates please rise? Caroline Craven Duncan, a biology major. Samantha Nicole Geltz, an astrophysics major. Alora Nicole Grogan, computing in the arts major. And Jane Crane McNamee, business administration major. I would like to ask those on stage to remain seated in order for the audience to see the candidates. However, it is the tradition here at the College of Charleston that the audience stands for this degree and when this degree is awarded. So would the audience in the Cistern Yard please rise as you can.
Curatorabus, octoratatum, tribuentibus, hos humanis, inhumaniorabus, literis, placare, eruditos, gratum artium baccalaureatus admissi. Congratulations, you may now be seated. Next, joining me in awarding the degrees will be Chair Padgett, Provost Hind, Executive Vice President Wilson, and Governor McConnell, if you would like to join us. Professor Renard Harris from the School of Education, Health, and Human Performance, and Chris Corey from the Department of Biology will announce the names and majors of our graduates. Upon successful completion of all degree requirements, and with the recommendation of the faculty and the deans, I have the honor to present the bachelor's degree candidates of 2013.
Assisting with the graduates from the School of Business will be Associate Dean Renee Mueller. For the bachelor's degree in accounting, joining us will be Professor Roger Daniels, Chair of the Department. Okay. Alexandra Marie Bailey, magna cum laude. Angela Michelle Baer. Emily Barton Bergunier. Jenna Elizabeth Brookins, Emily Elizabeth Bush, cum laude. Thomas Bradshaw Clark, also meets requirements for business administration. Cameron Lee Close. Anna M. Crawford, cum laude. Caitlin Janelle Cunningham, also meets requirements for business administration. Michael Timothy Dangerfield. Casey Elaine Duplanchet, magna cum laude. Caroline G. Emerson. Michelle Erica Ginsburg, magna cum laude, also meets requirements for business administration. Anna Elizabeth Graham, cum laude. Christopher August Gribben. Robert Joseph Harding. Kristen Monique Hennigan. Stuart James Hill. Jamie Rachel Johnson, cum laude, also meets requirements for economics. Chase Montgomery Kiever, cum laude. Charles Joseph Kelchner III, magnum cum laude, also meets requirements for business administration. Brandon Noel Leeming. Anna Michelle Lewis. Corey William Marum. Jennifer Plummer Miller, cum laude. Ryan Thomas Miller. Catherine Squires Newkirk. Anthony Pearson, cum laude. Justin Carroll Ponder. Catherine J. Poston, also meets requirements for political science. Persephone N. Prelo. Alexander Hugh Rogers. Martha Elizabeth Salter. Melinda Shank, summa cum laude. Kat Sharishan. Megan Elizabeth Shevlin. Bridget Christine Smith, John Robert Spencer, cum laude, Allison Jane Sullivan, Stephanie Elaine Thomas, Samuel Bradley Tiller, Lauren Elizabeth Tonkovich, magna cum laude, Christopher Douglas Chabold, James P. Villanova, Philip Dean Whittington, magna cum laude, Caroline Elizabeth Wright, cum laude. Shannon Denisha Wright, cum laude. Anna Michelle Lewis. No? Anna? Amanda Paige Abatoff. For the bachelor's degree in business administration, joining us will be Professor Thomas Kent, chair of the department. Mackenzie Kate Armstrong. Jeffrey John Asheris. Nicholas Brian Baker. Shelby Nora Ball, cum laude, also meets requirements for the Honors College. The Honors College certificates were awarded by Dean Tricia Folds Bennett at a separate ceremony yesterday. Carolyn Rosemary Barnick, also meets requirements for hospitality and tourism management. Brandon Lee Barr. Christina Marie Berry. Virginia Catherine Best. Laura Elizabeth Bladeck. Adam Rhett Bloomberg. Katarina Bohm, also meets requirements for communication. Willard Irwin Boss. Darren M. Bolton. Megan Elizabeth Bowes, magna cum laude. Lindsay Rush Brand. Joshua Frederick Brister. Richard Xavier Burke. Casey Lane Burton. Molly Kate Cagino, also meets requirements for hospitality and tourism management. William H. Calvi. Julia Grace Campbell. Stephanie Jean Cardwell. Allison Coy Carpenter, cum laude. Carly Ann Carrier, cum laude. Emily Lauren Casanova. Morgan Patrick Chapman. William Putnam Chapman. Courtney Joe Clark, also meets requirements for hospitality and tourism management. Carl Fletcher Klein. Daniel Vincent Cloy. Robert Joseph Croson III. William Kingsley Crowell. Cronin Reynolds Cullen. Anthony Maxwell Conti. William Ingersoll Danforth. Alan Markham DePoor, also meets requirements for hospitality and tourism management. Diana Lynn Donahue. Richard Graham Duncan. John Patrick Edwards. Michelle Danielle Eichenberg. Moshe Eliyahu. Melissa Ann Elliman. Morgan Marie Elvis. Lucian William Evans. Leah Danielle Fetter. Jill Ellen Feraldi, also meets requirements for hospitality and tourism management. Adam Jonah Finer. Megan Marie Fisher. Lauren Elizabeth Flatley, cum laude. James Michael Flato Jr. Taylor Leanne Floss. Lauren Elizabeth Foster, cum laude. Chrissy Lee Fusigna. Justin Tate Funderburk. Aisha Shaniqua Gadsden. Patrick Christian Gooding. Nicholas Evans Gore. Bradley Michael Gorman. Christopher Morgan Graham. Stuart Russell Grant, also meets requirements for studio art. Eleanor Blair Gumenick, cum laude. Cameron Robert Hall, magna cum laude. Willis Collins Hall. Tess Amelia Halperin, cum laude. George Cleveland Hancock. Kenneth Maximilian Hanover. Amanda Jean Hardwick. Robert Charles Hartley. Joseph Blake Harwood. Thomas Robinson Henry. Melissa Wynn Hertzfeld, also meets requirements for hospitality and tourism management. Michelle Leanne Hogan. Robin Elizabeth Hoke. Tyler Stephen Horde. Vincent Houdon. John Duke Hudson, also meets requirements for hospitality and tourism management. Rachel Caroline Hunter. Jeffrey William Hurwitz. Haley Ann Hutchins, magna cum laude. Dustin Norman Height. Catherine Chisholm Inkley. Egypt Ayesha Israel. Victoria Rose Jennings, Samuel Royston Johannes, Austin Scott Johnson, Rodney Boyce Johnson, James Arthur Julian IV, Jacqueline Marie Kasberg, Willis Christopher Keith, Catherine Diener Kerr, William Joseph Kenny, Devin Morgan Kiernan, also meets requirements for hospitality and tourism management, Sean Philip Kirby Smith, Brittany Nicole Knox, Robert Chandler Kahn, Nicholas A. Laganella, Derek Hansen Lambden, Paige Catherine Langreby, Melanie Crystal Langdon, magna cum laude, Joseph David Largura, Dante Mariano La Rufa, Daniel Bruce Lauder, Victoria Ann Lebline, cum laude, Hunter Elliott Lee, Daniel Carson Lewis, Mary Teresa Lillis, Jenna Locke, also meets requirements for hospitality and tourism management, Brandon Kyle Long, Crystal Nicole Long, Molly Ann Love, Amanda Cherie Lucarelli, Shannon Lucas, Susan Elizabeth Lynch, Christopher W. Mace, Jason Robert Marks, Julian Evan Matkins, Marianne Sidonia Martin, Paige Mitchell Martin, Mary Catherine Masco, cum laude, Christopher Gambling McGahey, Brian Kevin McNamara, Jane Crane McNamee, cum laude, Chase Morgan McShay, Richard Paul Meebon, Zoe Elizabeth Merritt, also meets requirements for hospitality and tourism management, Samuel Jacob Metzger, Stephanie Gabrielle Militello, Manning Edward Miller, Kylie Marie Murky, Brian Thomas Muller, Ryan Edward Mullen, Andrew Michael Mullinax, Brittany Lee Mutterer, Dylan Robert Nadeau, Jordan Catherine Knapper, Casey Marie Nelson, James Paul Newman, Brendan Thomas Nichols, Barbara Nistor, Zachary Paul Ostrowski, cum laude, Christopher Ryan Otten, Heather Brittany Pate, Jared Anthony Pavlik, Samantha Ann Pierman, James Matthew Pegler, Franklin Munchak Peters, Laura K. Pouncey, cum laude, Danielle Francis Powell, Matthew P. Prescott, Arbor Rossi, Alexandra Dorothy Rice, also meets requirement for hospitality and tourism management. Alexander Joseph Rifflin, Caroline Elizabeth Roberts, Morgan Carol Robinson, cum laude, Catherine McDaniel Rogers, Brandon Michael Rolfus, Eleanor Reagan Rose, cum laude, Caitlin Michelle Roulard, also meets requirements for hospitality and tourism management, Catherine Ann Runkel, also meets requirements for hospitality and tourism management, Hannah Danielle Ruth, Joffrey Isaiah Samuels, Stephanie Laura Sailors, Claire Antonia Schwartz, Alexis Paige Scott, Cameron Gray Sepulveda, Anna Elizabeth Sheely, Henry Kirkland Wingate Sherrill, Stephen McKinnon Shisko, Alexandra Yurievna Silvernail, Jillian Doris Sirico, Jillian Doris Sirico, Amanda Gail Slekta, magna cum laude, Meredith Francis Sopko, also meets requirements for hospitality and tourism management, Lisa Catherine Spence also meets requirements for hospitality and tourism management. Elizabeth Sargent Stewart, cum laude. Seth Zachary Stewart also meets requirements for hospitality and tourism management. Jacqueline Michelle Sullivan, magna cum laude. Shannon Lauren Tague also meets requirements for arts management. Grayson Baxter Thomas. Therese Thuy Tran. Devin Joel Turner. Gregory Ulbrich. Patrick Upson, Business Administration. Jonathan Vanden Verken. Amber Marie Venters. Kirk Michael Vitello, cum laude. Kyla Marie Wagner. Nicholas Jarvis Walker. Chow Wong. Marcus DeAndre Watts. Andre Charles Waymont. Haley Renee Virasing. Ava Julia Weinstein. Tema Jennifer Weissman. Matthew Robert Welch. Caroline J. West also meets requirements for arts management. Elizabeth Arden Weston. Miles Graham White. Stephen Mark Wilk, cum laude. For the bachelor's degree in economics, joining us will be Professor Peter Calgagno, representing the department. Christopher David Banholzer. Francis Joseph Berger IV also meets requirements for history. Evan Robert Blackwell, magna cum laude, also meets requirements for business administration. William Thomas Boyer. Joshua D. Coward. Benjamin Haley Hansen Cox. Andrew Thomas Dosher III. Christina Dubois. Brendan Joseph Feria. Dylan Andreo Fernandez also meets requirements for political science. James William Angus Gambill, magna cum laude, also meets requirements for business administration and the Honors College. James Nicholas Garrelis, cum laude. Charles Martin Grant. Colin Dean Hodges. Francis Elizabeth Jones. William Carroll Joyce. Last name. Charles Munson Lanier III also meets requirements for history. Lance Robert Maynard, magna cum laude. Maxwell Charles McEachern. James Michael McManus, summa cum laude, also meets requirements for history. Robert Jeffrey Nadeau. Kelly Lynn O'Brien, cum laude, also meets requirements for business administration. David Christopher O'Hara. Michael Morrison Ramming. Philip Augustus Rosenman. John Corey Ross.
Middle name?
Prius. Bruno Prius Rotundo. Christopher Courtney Ruffle. Dane Bly Schemmel. Hart St. Clair Smodick. Benjamin Sean Spector also meets requirements for accounting. Freddie Justin Strickland. Martin Cotney Summer. Lauren Albee Taylor. Benjamin Lee Tokarsik, cum laude. Andrew Renard Trexel. James Gambriel Utt Jr. Diane Ashley Vaught, magna cum laude, also meets requirements for mathematics and the Honors College. James Penders Vonderleith, cum laude, also meets requirements for the Honors College. Peter Thomas Wysocki. Matthew Thomas Zutel. For the bachelor's degree in hospitality and tourism management, joining us will be Professor Wayne Smith, representing the department. Lily Therese Andorski also meets requirements for business administration. Rachel Brina Benaroff, cum laude, also meets requirements for business administration. Sydney Fowler Bloomberg also meets requirements for business administration. Laura Marie Farrington Bishop also meets requirements for business administration. Alexandra Rose Carroll also meets requirements for business administration. Kelsey Klass, also meets requirements for business administration. Hannah Alexandra Corey, also meets requirements for business administration. Megan Elizabeth Costin, also meets requirements for business administration. Chandler Lynn Crocker. Karina Marie DeColibus, also meets requirements for business administration. Aaron Louise Irwin, also meets requirements for business administration. Hannah Elizabeth Ferguson, also meets requirements for business administration. Morgan Amelia Furman, also meets requirements for business administration. Sarah Jean Flanders. Daria Rose Friedman. Chelsea Rowena Garland, also meets requirements for business administration. Allison Margaret Gershevsky, cum laude, also meets requirements for business administration. Katie Adelaide Gilmer, cum laude, also meets requirements for business administration. Chanel Alva Goldberg, also meets requirements for business administration. Sarah Elizabeth Goldberg, also meets requirements for business administration. Jason Harris Hagwood. Savannah Michelle Johnson, also meets requirements for business administration. Jeffrey Thomas Carney. Michael Ryan Kempton, also meets requirements for business administration. Amy Lynn Knobloch, summa cum laude, also meets requirements for business administration. Bethany Francis Kosak, also meets requirements for business administration. Michael Benjamin Labraska, also meets requirements for business administration. Allison Ann Ladley, also meets requirements for business administration. Amanda Michelle Martin, also meets requirements for business administration. Amanda Colby McCarthy, also meets requirements for business administration. Ray Ann McLean, also meets requirements for business administration. Amanda Rose McKenna, also meets requirements for business administration. Jacqueline Taylor McPhail. Matthew David Moore, also meets requirements for business administration. Dana Nicole Norton. Mimi Alexandra Pappas, also meets requirements for business administration. Monica Marie Pearson, also meets requirements for business administration. Francesca Piedimonte, summa cum laude, also meets requirements for business administration in the Honors College. Carly Ray Petraca, magna cum laude, also meets requirements for business administration. Brianna Kirsten Plotzer, cum laude, also meets requirements for business administration. Georgia Nelson Richardson, also meets requirements for business administration. Caitlin Elizabeth Shearer, also meets requirements for business administration. Joshua Allen Schoenhar, also meets requirements for business administration. Christopher Simba Franklin Schreiber, also meets requirements for business administration. Gretchen Ariana Shoemaker. Lindsay Catherine Snooks. Alyssa Catherine Stavola, also meets requirements for business administration. Aaron Pace Stegman, also meets requirements for business administration. Danielle Rose Tedonio, also meets requirements for business administration. Elizabeth Watkins Urban, also meets requirements for business administration. Amber Nicole Van Patten, cum laude, also meets requirements for business administration. Emma Elizabeth Versaw, also meets requirements for business administration. Laura Jane Warren, also meets requirements for business administration. Morgan Nicole Wetherington, also meets requirements for business administration. Ashley Brooke Wilbur. Mary Catherine Wimberly, also meets requirements for business administration. Amanda Catherine Zeal, also meets requirements for business administration. For the bachelor's degree in international business, joining us will be Professor Julia Blows, chair of the department. Kyle Everett Alligood. Anisha Rajesh Amin. Natalie Elizabeth Andriano. Jessica Ann Bernacki. Randy Wayne Blankenship, cum laude. Alexandra Mihaela Bokai, cum laude. Sarah Ware Boyder. Philip Braun. Jeffrey Tyler Brooks, summa cum laude, also meets requirements for Spanish in the Honors College. Michael Joseph Cook. Grant Edward Cox. Sean William Crowley. Alexandra Elizabeth Diome. Caitlin Faye Ann Dewar. Morgan Ashley Edwards. Sonia Cecilia Eitzel, cum laude. Elizabeth Ann Elliott, Benjamin Graff, cum laude, Marita Ray Hansen, Allison Kate Harbeck, cum laude, also meets requirements for art history in the Honors College, Catherine Ann Holton, Esteban Hoyos, Annie Dukes Hurt, Mark Kadoshnikov, cum laude, Michael Ryan Kelly, Robert Stephen Klostermeyer, Leah J. Magan, cum laude, Mackenzie Mason, Tyler Matthew Neal, Kate Elizabeth Newsom, Ainoa Nogales, Maria Josefina Pallier, Emily Ann Pedersen, also meets requirements for Spanish. Alyssa Marie Parola, cum laude, also meets requirements for French and Francophone studies. Ross Alexander Poletti, also meets requirements for the Honors College. Emily Ann Smith. Roxanne Elizabeth Rice, cum laude. Hannah Allison Toby. Nicholas Graham Tuttle. Tyler Charles Vukoder. Sarah Chase Weber. Nicholas Francis Wagren, Blake Nathan Williams, John Benjamin Weil, William Winston. Assisting with the graduates from the School of Education, Health, and Human Performance will be Dean Francis Welch. For the bachelor's degree in athletic training, joining us will be Professor Michael Flynn, chair of the department. Paige Louise Childers, cum laude, also meets requirements for physical education. Brittany Reed Crosby, magna cum laude, also meets requirements for physical education. Amy Ellen Evans. For the bachelor's degree in early childhood education, joining us will be Professor Maida Van Sickle, chair of the department. Alexa Albanese. Lindsay Christine Allen. Ashley Livingston Baker, cum laude. Marshall Irby Beal, cum laude. Ailey Jo Charon. Megan Yvonne Chase, Pauline Dixon Clover, Craig Michael Deutsch, cum laude, Megan Kelly Fernandez, Jordan Elise Fogarty, Anna Christine Garrett, cum laude, Lindsay Kathleen Gauze, magna cum laude, Emily Kate Gibbons, cum laude, Stacy Dale Goodwin, Caroline Elizabeth Graham, top honors, J.C. Leanne Gross, Alexandra Georgette Houston, cum laude, Martha Jeffries Hill, Georgia Ann Howard, Sarah Lynn Au, magna cum laude, Rachel Blackwell Jones, Kayla Marie Canesto, Molly A. Lofton, Tirsen Mariah Meyer, cum laude, Jessica Hannah Meelan, Sean Lee Metzger, Ashley Ann Mitchum, Amanda M. Moore, cum laude, Elena Renee Novak, magna cum laude, Toby Anna Rubin, Kristen Beatty Self, Carrie Danielle Sharp, Catherine Hillary Sampson, cum laude, Sarah Elise Steinberg, cum laude, Melissa Ann Swikart, cum laude, Kitty Calhoun Tackett, cum laude. Brittany Marie Talent. Jordan Beverly Tinsman. Amber Lindsay Tourville. Melinda Shannon Turner. Sierra Nicole Wilkie. Nina Christine Zorch. For the bachelor's degree in elementary education. Hannah Lynn Atafi, cum laude. Sarah Elizabeth Carpenter, magna cum laude. Amanda Noelle Chapman, cum laude. Caitlin Marie Chavez. Victoria C. Druce. Stephanie Marie Eggeman. Jared Arthur Gambrell. Vanessa Michelle Hancock. Amy Shannon Hartnett, cum laude. Hannah Elizabeth Heron, cum laude. Skylar Dane Hoyle. Christopher Edward Humphreys, Emily Elizabeth Kleinberg, Tamil Sherelle Leach, Sarah Margaret Morris, cum laude, Amanda Lynn Ray Nunez, Lauren E. Ross, Jeremiah Lee Sams, Shane Michael Silpe, cum laude, Angelica Audrey Smith, cum laude, Chelsea Mariah Taylor, Christy Catherine Virtue, cum laude.
For the bachelor's degree in exercise science, joining us again will be Professor Michael Flynn, chair of the department. Today's graduates are the first for this program. Miriam Mahmoud Bwaza, cum laude. Elise Chappelle Clark. Nancy Hayes Cromer. Victoria Marie Crouch. Gretchen Ray Davis. Kelsey Olivia Davis, cum laude, also meets requirements for the Honors College. Mark Warren DeFranzo. Victoria Marie Edgington. Carly Morgan Fader, cum laude. Angela Megan Farr. Kenneth Ontario Felder. Wanda Finvesh. Tara Marie Gagnon, magna cum laude. Kaylee Ellen Gardner, cum laude. Samantha Young Garrison. Alyssa McGann Harville. Kimberly Michelle Havel, magna cum laude. Franklin Henry Hayes. Tyler Leanne Head. Ashley Melissa Heaton. Danielle Blair Herlong, cum laude. Danielle Irene Herman. Matthew McBurney Hoffmeyer. Kenrick Jose Cantala. Tara Alexandra Kay, cum laude. Olivia Catherine Lang, cum laude. Jelaine LaShawn MacArthur. Jason Michael Middlebrooks. Kayla Lynn Noonan. Amanda D. Parker. Catherine Ann Poletti. Dustin Chase Reeder. Michelle Robles, cum laude. Taylor McCarty Sleaford, cum laude. Jessica Stambalou. Christine Price Stokes. Sarah Elizabeth Thomas, cum laude. Ashley Nicole Verone. Anna Louise Walker, cum laude. Justin Neil Williamson. For the bachelor's degree in middle grades education, joining us again will be Professor Maida Van Sickle, chair of the department. Kelsey Diane Clark, cum laude. Alicia Marie Corsell, Anne Louise Cotterill, Jillian Elizabeth Cronin, cum laude. Tyson William Dutton, Lauden Elise Gamble, Nicole Judith Gregg, cum laude. Hannah Elizabeth Leonard, Ashley Nicole McNeely, Ariana Michelle Mitchell, Weldon C. Mumford, Shaniqua Monique Mustafer, Michael Benjamin Newberry, Julia Rose Nygren, Adam Cook Siri, Casey Elizabeth Taylor. For the bachelor's degree in physical education, joining us again will be Professor Michael Flynn, chair of the department. Paige Lynette Anderson, Monica Charisse Bignard. India Nate Broadwater also meets requirements for Spanish. Brittany Nicole Crow also meets requirements for secondary education. Catherine Ann Dorr, cum laude. Ryan Timothy Dugan. Aaron Stevens Gruber. Christine Ann Harvey. Kelsey Danae Hawkins. Margaret Mellon Hayes. Jordan Erica Holland, magna cum laude. Ashley Marie Jones. Courtney Christina Kelly. Colin Andrew Leary also meets requirements for secondary education. Emily Irene McCabe. Kara Elizabeth McGann. Daniel John Murphy. Layla Sarah Neal, cum laude, also meets requirements for secondary education. Nicholas Robert Pucciati. Jimmy Grant Rivon. Kelsey Brian Shea, cum laude, also meets requirements for secondary education. Christopher A. Taylor, also meets requirements for secondary education. Evelyn McGrath Triber, cum laude. Dominicus J. Valunas. For the bachelor's degree in public health, today's graduates are the first for this program. Caitlin Brianna Altman, Erica Bain, Elizabeth Ann Brewer, Elizabeth Catherine Bruce, Lindsay Chandler Davis, Grace Elizabeth Herlong, cum laude, Alyssa Nicole Hyder, cum laude, Francis Burkhead Brown Knowlton, Lauren O'Neill Layard, Devin Jacqueline McClary, Jessica Tiana Parker, Natasha Marguerite Pavlovich, magna cum laude, Michelle Marie Rains, Emily Christina Tinga, Sarah Spillman Tufts, Beth Renee Ulick, cum laude, Ann Catherine Yules, Sarah Rose Whitehead, Carrington Rose Wilson, Lauren Brooke Zerbst, for the bachelor's degree in secondary education cognate, joining us again will be Professor Maida Van Sickle, chair of the department. Sarah Nicole Bohr also meets requirements for sociology. Megan Elizabeth Collins also meets requirements for physics. Rachel Lee Davis, summa cum laude, also meets requirements for English and religious studies. Jason George Williams also meets requirements for history. For the bachelor's degree in special education, Allison Lee Chilton, Jessica Louise Dory, Mary Catherine Elliott, Courtney Ann Hickman, Caitlin A. Gilly, magna cum laude, Courtney Ruth Leonard, Heather Nicole Lorraine, Rebecca Dawn Lowry, summa cum laude, Tracy Leanne Madden, magna cum laude, Sarah Clark Marchant, Mary Frances McGuire, Ashley Margaret Mercero, Madison Michelle Nix, Laura Walker Penny, Jessica Elizabeth Ralston, Monica Lynn Reed, Tony R. Schneider, Shelby Sims, Meredith Dawn Schaefer, magna cum laude, Lindsay Rose Thomas. Assisting with the graduates from the School of Science and Mathematics will be the Dean Michael Arbach. For the bachelor's degree in astrophysics, joining us will be Professor Narayanan Kuthiramal, chair of the department. Kevin Michael Ganey, cum laude. Samantha Nicole Geltz also meets requirements for history and classics. For the bachelor's degree in biology, joining us will be Professor Yap Hellenius, chair of the department. Jonathan Edward Aker. Christina George Amish, also meets requirements for psychology. David Joseph Applebaum. Christopher Charles Asuzu, cum laude. Isatu Ba. Anne Marie Baker. Ethan Patrick Beckett, excuse me, cum laude. Alana Renee Berdanier. Matthew Gregory Berger, cum laude, also meets requirements for the Honors College. Jason Philip Bylow. Sarah Ann Brazina, cum laude. Brian Tamaki Bertain. Taylor Britton. Morgan Brown. Stephen Michael Brown, cum laude. Courtney Gibson Brown, summa cum laude, also meets requirements for the Honors College. Victoria Elizabeth Bufford, cum laude. Robert Colin Burnham, cum laude. Michael Patrick Cannon. Krista Elizabeth Caperton. Casey Christopher Chubb. Stephanie Marie Clark. Melody Adina Coakley. Joseph Henry Cause. Lauren Alexandra Crowley. Mary Elizabeth Crow, cum laude, also meets requirements for the Honors College. Elizabeth Lee Curtis, also meets requirements for psychology. Kristen Darlene Daniel. Hunter Allen Daniels. Lydia Kathleen Davidson, cum laude. Sarah Ellen Davis, cum laude, also meets requirements for studio art. Natalie Pate Dennis. Kyle John Dolan. Rachel Ann Dotson. Jamie Renee Douglas, Mary Catherine Duff, Caroline Craven Duncan, cum laude, also meets requirements for the Honors College. Sarah Elizabeth Dungo, cum laude. Bethany Ann Dyer, Marietta Rosa Easterling, Rachel Corinne Ekdahl, cum laude, also meets requirements for studio art and the Honors College. Maria Elena Felice, also meets requirements for the Honors College. Sean Michael Ferguson, cum laude. Elizabeth May Friend. Marco Gattoni Celli, cum laude. Peter Gibbons. Trent Daniel Gillingham. Amelie Stevens Jarisco, cum laude. Andrew Lau Gunderson. Olivia Leigh Gunter. Lauren Michelle Olivanich. Lindsay Nicole Olivanich. Stephanie Ann Haney. Leah Alexandra Highfield, cum laude. Megan Lee Therese Hilbert, magna cum laude, also meets requirements for the Honors College. Olivia Melanie Hertz Wilson, cum laude. Delia Shireen Elizabeth Halubi. Anthony James Horton, summa cum laude, also meets requirements for the Honors College. Lauren Ann Howe, Skylar Jade Hughes, Emily Hunter Huser, Arielle Nicole Emler, cum laude, Tyler Brent Inabinet, Trent Daniel Gillingham, Melissa Rebecca James, magna cum laude, also meets requirements for the Honors College. Maliana Rose Judd, also meets requirements for the Honors College. Erica Ryan Juris. Melissa Ann Juskovitz. Miriam Adair Keenan. Annie Grace Kellner. Charlotte Rose Kelsey. Brian Spencer Kenyon. Cameron Michelle Kinsley. Aaron Nicole Kirby, Magenta Anna Elizabeth Klein, Leslie Walker Leek, cum laude, also meets requirements for psychology, Christopher Brad Long, cum laude, Erin May Lukowiak. Brandy A. McGanna, cum laude. Michael Justin Mai, also meets requirements for psychology. Fiona Grace Maley. Julia Lynch Martins. Ryan Elizabeth Martin. Bennett Richard May, also meets requirements for the Honors College. Jessica Elizabeth McAllister. Jordan J. McCarthy, cum laude, also meets requirements for psychology and the Honors College. Emily R. McKee. Erin Elizabeth McPherson, cum laude, also meets requirements for the Honors College. Jessica Greer McNutt. Daniel Sherwood Myler IV, cum laude. Blake Aaron Miller, also meets requirements for secondary education cognate. Michael Vincent Morris. Andrea Catherine Nekadam, cum laude. Christina Min Newman. David Scott Nichols, magna cum laude. Caroline Franchella Norris, cum laude. Jacob Levi Oblander. Skylar Spring O'Hara. Jeremiah Bradley Olson, magna cum laude. Manali Mukesh. Manali Mukesh Patel. Pooja Manish Patel, cum laude, also meets requirements for the Honors College. Shrey P. Patel. Samantha Jordan Patterson. Ariane Nicole Pereira, magna cum laude. Devin Page Patron. Thomas Joseph Pittman, magna cum laude. Christiana Jeanette Porter. Jenna Monogan Powell. Kelly Vanessa Pruitt. Katie Jean Randall. Tatiana Zoni Reinhard. Mary Hannah Rien. Jillian Elizabeth Robertson. Sarah Florence Rogers. Mary Elizabeth Rumble, magna cum laude, also meets requirements for the Honors College. Brian Maxwell Rutsey. Christina Michelle Schwartz, cum laude. Gabriel Charles Segura. Tracy Miriam Shames. Sarah Christine Shelton, cum laude. Casey Shane Smith. Louise Allsbrook Smunk. Naringa Stankevich Ute. Rachel Elaine Stelling, cum laude. Rachel Christine Stevens. Colleen Brittany Stutfin. Tara Francis Swayze, cum laude. Kareen Jamal Taha. Benjamin Michelle Mitchell Tester. Lane Elizabeth Thomas, cum laude. Catherine Brooke Thomason, magna cum laude. Carolyn Kelly Thorison, cum laude. Alyssa Marie Thornton, cum laude, also meets requirements for psychology. Henry Holland Tomlinson, also meets requirements for the Honors College. Jacqueline Cushing Tully. Ashley Ferry Valipour, magna cum laude. Patrick Alfred Van Wert. Shalice Eleanor Vick. Edward Vernon Veeman. Navardo Peter Vivar, also meets requirements for political science. Joshua Roger Volton, cum laude, also meets requirements for the Honors College. Brittany Page Wallace, also meets requirements for English. Tess Elizabeth Warther. Forrest Halsey Wesley. Annika Ellen Wilder, magna cum laude, also meets requirements for the Honors College. Samantha Grace Wiles, cum laude. Courtney Reback Williams, cum laude, also meets requirements for sociology. Gloria Jane Wilson. Caitlin Margaret Winkler, cum laude. Zachary Kyle Worsham. Cindy Wu. For the bachelor's degree in biochemistry, joining us will be Professor Pamela Riggs Jalasco, chair of the department. Kimber Marie Amweg, cum laude, also meets requirements for chemistry and the Honors College. Kristen Ann Arabia, also meets requirements for chemistry. Cassandra Jamae Ballow. Hayden Presley Barrett. Samuel Martin Elchek, also meets requirements for chemistry. Travis Kendall Faith, cum laude, also meets requirements for the Honors College. Coretta Kaswana Goss, magna cum laude. Jordan Renee Greenway. Shulia, also meets requirements for the Honors College. Hannah Alicia Hughes, summa cum laude, also meets requirements for the Honors College. Robert Daniel Little, Jr. Miriam Michaela Mayer, magna cum laude. Ethan Alexander Merrow. Lauren Ashley McDonald. Carly Michelle Muller. London Ross Penland, magna cum laude. Ariana Faith Quattlebaum, also meets requirements for the Honors College. John Arthur Scaringi, cum laude, also meets requirements for chemistry and history. Sarah Beth Scheidley, magna cum laude, also meets requirements for the Honors College. Corey David Sechrist, magna cum laude, also meets requirements for chemistry and biology. Heather Elizabeth Wright, top honors. For the bachelor's degree in chemistry, Robert Brent Arthur, Catherine Juliana Beaver, Virginia Ashley Culp, Danielle Alexandra Edwards, cum laude, Jessica Lee Hatcher, Michelle Lynn Iantuano, Kaylin Elizabeth Johnson, also meets requirements for biochemistry and the Honors College, Kevin Matthew Kempton, cum laude, Kimberly Ruth Kloss, Charity Marie Nora, Jonathan Stewart Smith. For the bachelor's degree in computer information systems, joining us will be Professor Christopher Starr, chair of the department. Matthew Kenter Blauwels. Robert Fitz, also meets requirements for computer science. Jaleesa Marie Green. For the bachelor's degree in computer science, William Woodrow Beneker. Also meets requirements for the Honors College. Jason Alton Daniel. Jeffrey Ryan Decker. Kyle Hagen. Hunter Hegler. Also meets requirements for computing in the arts. Joanna Marie Illing, magna cum laude. Casey Allen Jackson. Israel Elizabeth James. Micah Knox Jenkins. Trevor James Mahard, Joshua M. Moore, Hannah Lauren Murray, cum laude, also meets requirements for computing in the arts and the Honors College, Brett Tyler Otswalt, Laye Peter Quay, Tyler Matthew Alexander Sawyer, David Malachi Sherdwan, Kyle Stephen Sproles, Matthew Constantine Viveras, cum laude, also meets requirements for the Honors College. For the bachelor's degree in computing in the arts, Alora Nicole Grogan, cum laude. For the bachelor's degree in discovery informatics, Austin Mitchell Axel, Leslie Moore Blackwell, magna cum laude. Jeffrey David Gardner, Matthew Brian Mazzarell, cum laude, Daniel Thomas Seiger, cum laude, Dita Carlson Thomas, cum laude, Melissa Sarah Wheel, cum laude. For the bachelor's degree in geology, joining us will be Professor Mitchell Colgan, chair of the department, Jacqueline Marie Alexander, Francis McGill Bastard, Matthew Hall Christie, William Ketterson Edwards, Brandon Dominic Farrow, Heather Lynn Flowers, magna cum laude, Matthew Cameron Hughes, Lindsay Ray Lowry, Lydia Beck Nicholas, summa cum laude, also meets requirements for the Honors College, Alicia Marie Raymond, summa cum laude, also meets requirements for arts management, Morgan Lee Schumann, Caroline Elizabeth Smith, For the bachelor's degree in marine biology, joining us will be Professor Hop Hellenius, chair of the department. Olivia Marjorie Ahern. Christopher Amos Bartlett. Daniel Alexander Bonanno. Rachel Marie Brighty. Patrick John Burke. Stacy Michelle Calhoun, magna cum laude, also meets requirements for Spanish. Vincent Italo Cellini. Arielle Rose Christensen. Amanda Milette Cole, magna cum laude, also meets requirements for the Honors College. Eden Lee Couch. Andrew Michael Demas, cum laude. Andrew Joseph Eads, cum laude. Elmira Jane Gandhi, also meets requirements for the studio art. Lucas Powell Griffin. Brittany Danielle Gunther, also meets requirements for psychology. Lauren Heather Hayes. Daniel Warren Hodge, magna cum laude. Rebecca Ann Lyson, cum laude. Erica Ann Levine, magna cum laude, also meets requirements for the Honors College. Chase Alexander Medlin. Hallie Margaret Meeks. Miles David Prados, magna cum laude, also meets requirements for French and Francophone Studies in the Honors College. Annie Jean Rendelman, cum laude. Hallie Jo Schultz. Eric Stephen Spear. Scott Allen Sundum, Jr. For the bachelor's degree in mathematics, joining us will be Professor Robert Minion, chair of the department. Palin Ogbiak. Daniel Patterson Allen, Jr. Taylor Langdon Blanton. Virginia Catherine Broadway, also meets requirements for secondary education cognate. Michael Robert Cornish, magna cum laude, also meets requirements for economics. Jessica Lauren Jones. Amber Pearl Lehman, cum laude, also meets requirements for the Honors College. Madeline N. Mikowski. Vincent Blake Mann. Matthew West Olivetti. Andrew Joseph Passarello, cum laude. Joseph Randich, magna cum laude. Taryn Lewis Schoenfeld. Chadley Stephen Scruggs, cum laude. Mark Nelson Ciso, cum laude, also meets requirements for economics. Wesley Brewer Spears. Abigail Lee Weimer, summa cum laude. John Tyler Williamson. Li Shen Yao. For the bachelor's degree in physics, joining us will be Professor Narayanan Kithuramal, church chair of the department. Michael David Shoot. Thea Kozakis, summa cum laude, also meets requirements for astrophysics. Matthew Nicholas Marvin, also meets requirements for secondary education cognate and astronomy. Hunter Gregory Moss. Benjamin Howard Rickman. Marco Antonio Rodriguez Cote. Laura Elizabeth Stevens, also meets requirements for biology and astrophysics. Mark Andrew Wells, magna cum laude, also meets requirements for astrophysics.
Will the candidates for bachelor's degrees please rise? By the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees and on the recommendation of the faculty and the deans of the College of Charleston, I hereby confer upon each of you the degree of Bachelor of Arts or Bachelor of Science as earned, with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities thereto appertaining. Congratulations. I would now like to acknowledge the faculty of the college. They deserve the credit for the quality, the success, the reputation, and the student-focused culture of the College of Charleston. They have earned our thanks. Would you please stand? Thank you. Graduates, I know that you got to this point mostly on your own, but credit should also go to your families and friends, the support system that they provide is critical in the educational process. I would now like the parents and the grandparents, the spouses, and other family and friends to please stand and let all of us thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, one more time, the College of Charleston class of 2013. Would you please now stand for the alma mater led by Claire Elitch? The words of the alma mater can be found on the back cover of your program. Thank you, beautiful. Family and friends, would you please remain in place until the recessional is complete? Graduates, in order to avoid congestion around Porter's Lodge, would you please continue through Porter's Lodge and on down Glebe Street a little ways? Now, virtually all colleges and universities parade out of commencement ceremonies like this to beautiful classical music from the 18th or 19th centuries, but we're not like other universities, are we? We are Charleston. We are the College of Knowledge. Yeah. Chris, crank up the music.